This conference will now be recorded.
Right, guys. Good morning, everyone. In the last class, we are trying to understand what is mocking and how to perform this mocking and why we need to go for mocking and what are several mock frameworks are available in the market. Right. So, what is mocking? Mocking is process of creating substitute object for real object. Mocking is a process of creating substitute object for real object. Mocking is very important as part of unit testing. Mocking is very important as part of unit testing. Mocking is very important as part of unit testing. So to test, to test our component in isolated manner, we are going to use this mocking. Isolated manner, we will use mocking. Right. So there are two types of mock frameworks are available. So what are those two types of mock frameworks? Come on, guys, please respond. What are the two types of mock frameworks we have? One is proxy-based mock frameworks, and the second one is bytecode manipulation mock frameworks. First one is proxy-based mock frameworks. Second one is bytecode manipulation mock frameworks. The example for proxy-based, EasyMock, and Mockito. EasyMock and Mockito are the proxy-based mock frameworks, whereas PowerMock and JMockit are. JMockit are the examples for bytecode manipulation based mock frameworks. Right. Now, so apart from this, it's nothing to revise from yesterday's session. Anybody who missed our yesterday's session, did anybody miss yesterday's session from this batch? Both 6 a.m. people and 11:30. If anybody missed it, please go through that video in the YouTube. Yesterday we had a live session for the class. That video is available in the YouTube. If anybody missed it, please watch that video. I think almost 2 hours class was conducted yesterday. You can watch that video in the YouTube. Right. Fine. So today we are going to develop some more methods by using mock framework. Yesterday I created only one method which will take a number and which will return a name. So today I'm going to deal with a method which is returning a list of objects and how to deal with a method which is throwing a exception, how we need to mock that. All right, let us see here. Now here I'm having a contact DAO. In the contact DAO, I have a method find name by ID, which is taking ID as a parameter and which is returning string as a return type. So for that, we have done mocking in our test class. So in order to do the mocking, here we are using a framework called EasyMock. This EasyMock belongs to proxy-based mocking framework. EasyMock.createMock, by passing the type of the class or interface for which you want to create the mock. I'm passing an interface, so for that interface, it created a proxy. That proxy we can't see with our eyes because that will be created in the runtime. Right. Once the proxy got created, it doesn't know any behavior. So we have to set the behavior for that proxy. In order to set the behavior for the proxy, we are using a method called EasyMock.expect. If somebody calls this method with this parameter and return this value, so that is what I am setting the behavior. So for 101, I told to mock object to return this value. For 102 method call, I told to return this value. Then I'm calling replay method. So reply is also a predefined method which is available in the easy mock. So switches the given mock, what is the purpose of this, right? Switches the given mock objects, the control of the mock objects to replay mode. For details, see the easy mock documentation, right? It is just used to get the control over the mock object, and it is going to save the behavior of that mock object. Fine. So after that, setting the behavior for the mock object, we are injecting our mock object to the service class by calling setter method of the service. Now service class will be talking to the mock object instead of talking to the real DAO. When I call my service layer method, that method will be interacting with the mock DAO method. And for the mock DAO method, already we have decided the behavior. So it is going to exhibit the behavior what we instructed to behave. Fine. Now, here let me take one more method. Public list. So my method is going to return list of strings. Then how can we mock it? List of strings, public list, Java util dot list, generic type is a string, find names, right? So from the table, I want to retrieve only names of the call, only names from the table. So name is a column available. So there are so many records are available. I want to retrieve all those names. Now, this method return type is list of string. This method return type is list of string, right? Fine. So coming to service layer, here I'm writing one method. In the service layer interface, I will write one method for this. Get all contact names. Public string get all contact names. It is not taking any parameter. It is just going to retrieve all the names available in the table. So it is then something like a projection. Retrieving the data which is really required. Retrieving the specific columns data from the table. So that is called projection. This method is meant for executing the projection query. Right. Now go to IMPL class of service. Overwrite this method. Get all contact names. As part of this method, we should call our DAO method. Sorry, here I have taken a string. It is list of strings. List of strings. As per our interface, it is list of string. Fine. Let me call the DAO method here. List of string. So here I'm going to call a method called contact DAO. Contact DAO dot find names. Contact DAO dot find names. Fine. It is going to return list of names for us. It is going to return list of names for us. Right. Fine. Next. So whatever the names I'm getting from this DAO, I'm going to check if names dot is not empty. If names dot is not empty, then I will return names, else I'm going to return null value. If names dot is empty, not operator. If names not empty, if that collection is not empty, I will return the names that came from the DB, else I'm going to return a null value. Now, so can I test this method directly without having the DAO implementation? Can I test my logic directly without having the DAO implementation, or I cannot test my method? Can I test it or I cannot test it? Please confirm. Now I have written one method in the service layer. Now my question is, can I test that method or I cannot test that method? We cannot test that method. The reason is our service layer method is talking to DAO layer method. Here we are having only DAO interface. there is no implementation for the DAO. There is no implementation for the DAO. Until unless we have that implementation, unit testing is not possible for this service component. Do I need to wait for the DAO implementation to be available, or I need to complete the unit testing of my component? Do we need to wait for the DAO implementation, or we need to complete unit testing for our component? We need to complete the unit testing for our component. Then how can I do that? By using mocking. Now I need to mock this method. When somebody call find names method, then I will tell to my mock object, return some names in the collection format. Return some names in the collection format, right? Now, so here we can write one method. In the unit testing method, I'm going to write now. Public void test get names underscore some 01. So that is first test case for our get names method. First test case for our get names method. Now here we need to write the code to perform the mocking. Now I am writing the code once again, guys. Please observe. Later we will optimize that code. So in order to the mock by using easy mock framework, we are having a method called easy mock dot create mock. For this, which interface you want to mock, that we need to pass as a parameter. Which is going to give us one object. Now I'm changing contact DAO of DAO proxy. It is a proxy object for us. Public void test get names underscore 01. In that I am writing one line of code, which is easy mock dot create mock. So what is the purpose of this create mock method? It is used to create the proxy for given interface. The proxy class will be created in the runtime. We can't see that class with our eyes. Once the DAO proxy got created, now we need to set the behavior for that. Here it is called creating mock object. Now set the behavior for mock. Right. Now what we need to do in order to set the behavior, we are going to call easy mock dot expect DAO proxy dot find names and return some collection. So whenever anybody calls that DAO method find names, it has to return that value. What value it has to return? Collection, list of strings it has to return. Now here I will prepare one list names is equal to new array list. I will add few names for that. Names dot add of some John. Names dot add of some Smith. And names dot add of some Peter. That's it. Now this is the data that I am sending for the mock method right now. So test public void test get names underscore 01. Fine. Now I prepared this names. So when somebody call this method find names, then you return this collection. Then what I'm going to do, easy mock dot replay of DAO proxy. Fine. So with this, I hope you got how we need to mock a method which is returning a collection, right? DAO method is supposed to return list of names. List of string, that means list of names are going to return from our DAO method. Actually, we don't have an implementation for that. So that's why I'm trying to mock this method. I'm trying to mock this method. So how I mock this method? First, I have decided what data my mock method has to return. Actually, if the DAO IMPL is available, it will get the data from the database. But the problem, we don't have that implementation. We don't have the IMPL class ready, right? Now, I need to return some names. When somebody calls that mock method, then I need to return some data. So to return the data, first I'm storing the data into the collection. List of string, few names I added to that collection. I've taken an array list object. Then I created my mock object. For the mock object, I am deciding the behavior also. I'm deciding the behavior also for the mock object. Next, create our service object. Contact service IMPL. Contact service IMPL. Service is equal to new contact service IMPL. New contact service IMPL. Now inject the object service dot set contact DAO. I'm going to set a DAO proxy object. Creating target object. Injecting proxy object into target. This can be called as setter injection. Creating target object. What is our target? Service IMPL is our target. We need to test that service IMPL method. For that service IMPL, we need a DAO. That's why I'm injecting that DAO through setter method. Can I call this as a setter injection, or I cannot call this as a setter injection? Come on. Can I call it as a setter injection, or I cannot call it as a setter injection? We can call it as a setter injection. We can call it as a setter injection because the dependent object is injected to target object through setter method. So we can call this as a setter injection. Fine. Next, call service layer method. Service dot get all contact names, which is going to return contact names. Which is going to return contact names for us. Right. Now, after we got this collection from the service layer method, I want to validate. How can I do validation of the unit testing results? Any idea? How can I validate unit testing results in the JUnit? What is the approach we need to follow to validate unit testing results in the JUnit? Come on, can you confirm how I need to validate unit testing results in the JUnit? By using asset methods. By using asset methods, right? Asset not null of contact names. Asset not null contact names. I have to get some data. I have to get some data that of that collection should not be null. Then only my case is passed. Asset not null. Whatever the collection I got, if that collection is not null, then only I will consider my case as passed case. Right. So fine. Here it is as of now, normal Java method. Now let us represent this as a JUnit test method. For that, I am writing @test annotation. So the purpose of @test to represent this method as JUnit method. Now, if you observe the code, so it is nothing new here. Yesterday also we had written the same functionality, but yesterday method was returning only one name. Today's method is going to return list of names. So how to mark a method which is returning a collection? Right. First, decide what data you want to return in the form of a collection. So I created a collection and I stored the data to the collection. Then I created a proxy object. Then I'm deciding the behavior for the proxy. Then I'm calling replay method. After that, I'm creating target class object. Which class method we want to unit test? Those class, that class object I'm creating. For that class, I'm injecting a dependent object. So dependent is a mock object here. I'm not injecting the real object because real object is not available. I'm just injecting a mock object through setter method. So this I can call as setter injection. Once that proxy got injected to the target, then I'm calling target class method, which is returning actual data, which is returning actual data for me, right? Once I got this data, then I'm checking whether this collection is null or not. Except not null. If this collection is not null, then I will consider this case as passed test case. Right. Now let's run and see. Two test cases are available. Both are using mocking. Here we performed that mocking by using EasyMock framework. That EasyMock framework belongs to proxy based mock framework. Right. Now I'm keeping a breakpoint at the 41 line number for the today's method. Now, yesterday's method I am not going to test it. Yesterday method already we tested. Now I don't want to test the yesterday's method again. Can I ignore the yesterday's method from the unit testing? Come on, guys. How can I ignore one method from the unit testing? By using a annotation call @ignore. Now we have a test. We are testing only today's method, which is first test case for the get names. Right click, debug as junit test. So I'm going to run this program in the debug mode so that we will have a better control on the program execution. Right. F6 for going for the next line. Proxy object created. Setting the behavior for the proxy object. Proxy.replay, which is used to save the behavior for the mock. Right, which is used to give the control to the mock object. Then I'm calling target. I'm creating object for target class, serve, which is contact service IMPL. Then as the contact service IMPL is dependent on the DAO, I'm injecting this DAO proxy. Please remember, before injecting the proxy object to the target, we need to set the behavior for the proxy. Right, so here I have decided the behavior already. After deciding the behavior only, then I'm injecting the proxy into my target. Now F6, here at the 60 line we are calling actual target class method. That is our service IMPL method. Let's get into that method execution. Now here I'm calling contact DAO dot find names. Now tell me what is happening at the 25th line. Come on, please message me in the chat box. What is happening at the 25th line? I hope you are able to see my screen. 25th line got highlighted. Just look at that line of code and tell me what is happening in that line. Yes, contact DAO dot find names. Contact DAO is a variable which is holding some, this is a variable belongs to interface. Contact DAO is a variable which is belongs to interface. Actually, we don't have implementation. In our project, we did not create any implementation for that DAO, right? If the DAO implementation is not available, how can I call that method? So that's where mock comes into picture. Now, this contact DAO variable is holding the proxy class object, which is considering as an implementation object for our interface. Now, this variable is holding proxy class object. Now, so whenever you call contact DAO.find names, it will call proxy object dot method name. It is going to give the priority to the proxy method, creating the object to the proxy method. What will happen is, whenever we are creating this proxy, all the methods will be part of that proxy, but behavior will not be available. We only decided the behavior for that proxy. So at the 25th line, actually proxy method is going to hit. As already I decided the behavior for the proxy, it is going to return the data, which is list of names. Whatever the names I told to return, it is returning exactly the same names. That means proxy is my slave. Whatever I will tell, it will perform that operation. I told to that proxy, when somebody called find names method, you return these three names in the form of collection. That is the instruction I have given to my proxy. As per my instruction, my proxy is behaving. Right. Now, here we have a condition. If names collection is not empty, then it is going to return the names only. Now, I got the names. Now, if asset not null of these names, then my test case is going to be passed. So total there are two methods are available. Those are called as two test cases. Every method you can call as one test case. Every method which contains at the rate test will be considered as one test case, right? So when we execute this test, you can observe the report generated by the J unit. Total there are two cases. Out of those, one got skipped because ignore. Nothing failed, nothing errored out, everything is successful. That is the reason green color status bar is displayed. It indicates all the tests are passed. Whatever the tests are executed, all the tests are passed. So I hope you understood how to mock a method which is returning a collection. First set the value, which collection values it has to return. Prepare that data. Then pass that data to mock as part of this return method. What collection it has to return? Just pass that data as part of this unwritten method. Just look at this code. 47, 49, those two lines are important. All of you clear with this one? Yeah, Vinash, we'll see that, sir. I will write it. All of you clear with this test case? Anybody has any questions? Any confusion? Clear. Good. Now, let me take one more method. Which is called as find by ID. Public. In the DAO, I'm taking one method. Public. That. We don't have any Pojo class, right? As of now, let me create one Pojo class for this. Now I am creating one Pojo class also. Let me call it as an entity. Right click, new class. Just I'm going to take it as a contact entity or contact, anything is fine. I'm taking this as a package model. In that, I'm taking a class with name called contact. Just taking three properties here. I did not add a Lombok dependency, so let me generate the setters and getters. Fine. We are able to generate the setters and getters for the variables available in this model class. Right. Now go to contact DAO. Public list of find names. Similarly, we are writing public contact find by ID. Find by ID. So based on the ID, it is going to return a contact object. Based on the ID, it is going to return a contact object. Now, get contact by contact ID. That is the method I'm going to write in the service layer. Import. Now this time this method is returning one object. This time this method is returning one object. Implement this method in the service layer. Get contact by ID. Get contact by ID. Fine. Now, so here we are going to write contact DAO dot find by ID. Find by ID. Now we are getting contact object. Now, so can you guarantee that always we'll retrieve get the data from the database, or we may not get the data from the database? There is no guarantee that always we'll get the data from the database, because whatever the ID I pass, with that ID, if the record is available, then only I will get this record. If the record is not available, then I will not get this record. You would understand? I can't say that always this method will give me the result. This method result is depends upon the ID that I am passing as a parameter. If I pass a valid ID, then it will return this object. If I pass the ID which is not available in the database, then this method is going to return null value. Are you able to follow this? Now, In this scenario, if contact not equal to null, then I need to return contact object. For example, if the contact is null, observe carefully. The 34 line number, I'm calling DAO.method by ID. Based on the ID, that method may return the contact object or may return a null value. If the record is available with the given contact ID, it will return the contact object. With the given ID, if the record is not available, then it will return a null value. If a contact not equal to null, then return this value. Otherwise, I want to throw one custom exception. So do you know how to throw a custom exception in the Java? Do you know how to throw a user defined exception in the Java? Come on. Yeah, now I want to I want to throw that custom exception from the service layer method. If the record is not available, then I want to throw an exception called no data found exception. No data found exception. Now, let me create one exception class. That I am keeping inside a package. No data found exception. No data found exception. Right. With this, here I'm going to extend properties from runtime exception. I'm going to extend the properties from runtime exception. So I'm writing one constructor, default constructor, and I will write one parameterized constructor also. Default constructor and parameterized constructor, I'm writing string message of super of message. Super of message. Now let's look at this. If I created one class which is going to be act as a custom exception class, in order to create a custom exception class, we are extending, in order to represent this class as an exception class, we are extending the properties from a predefined class called runtime exception. So where is runtime exception available? Runtime exception is a predefined class which is available in java.lang package. Runtime exception is the java.lang package. What is this? This is a super class of the exceptions that can be thrown during the normal operation of a Java virtual machine. So whenever your JVM is executing, if you want to throw any exception, then you can extend the properties from this runtime exception. Here I created one zero param constructor and I created one parameterized constructor also. Fine, perfect. Now go to service IMPL. If contact is equal to null. Now let me change this condition like this. If contact is equal to null, then just I want to throw. How to throw an exception in the Java? Using throw keyword or throws keyword? Do I need to use a throw keyword or I need to use a throws keyword? Throw or throws? Throw. Are you sure? Are you sure? Yes, throw keyword. Throw new no data found exception. Throw new no data found exception. Right. Now let's understand this method implementation. My service layer method is calling DAO method. My service layer method is calling DAO method. DAO may give the result, may not give the result. That depends upon the ID that I am supplying as a parameter. It depends upon the ID that I am supplying as a parameter. If given ID present in the database, then it will retrieve the record and it will give that. If the given ID does not present in the database, then this method will give the null object, right? If a contact record is null, if there is no record available, then I want to throw new data found exception. Then I want to throw new data found exception. If the contact record is available, then it is going to return contact object. Then it is going to return contact object. Now here, we need to test two scenarios for this method. As part of unit testing, I want to test two scenarios. Can you please confirm what are those two scenarios I need to test for this method? So if I give the valid ID, record is coming or not from the table. That is one scenario. If I give the invalid ID, exception is getting thrown by this method or not. That is the second scenario. So for one target method, we can write more than one test case also. For one target method, we can write more than one test case also. Right. Now, let us try to perform the testing for this method by using JUnit with the help of mocking. Contact service test. Right. Now, if you observe this code, do you see any problem in this code or you don't see any problem in this code? Do you see any problem in this code or you don't see any problem in this code? What is the problem? Come on, guys, what is the problem in this code? There is a boilerplate code. In this code, we are having a boilerplate code. So tell me, how can I avoid that boilerplate code in the test class? How can I avoid that boilerplate code? Every time I am creating the proxy. In every test, I am creating the proxy. Actually, it is not recommended. Create the proxy once, set all the behavior, then inject into our target. So can I optimize this code now? Now we are going to optimize this code to avoid that boilerplate code. Yes, we are going very slow. I hope you are able to understand the session. How I am trying to write the code. Fine. Public void static. Now I am going to take it as a init. Right? This should be executed as before class. This should be executed as before class. Public static void. Public static void. Now, whatever the behavior that we have done, let us cut this or let us copy this. For the first test case, whatever the logic we have written, I am copying this logic. I will keep this logic inside our init method. Proxy. Two times it got pasted. Right. What, why this much code? Why it copied for these many times? Yes. Now, inside the init method, I copied the code that was available in the first place, right? Now, let us go to the second scenario also. In the second scenario, this code is required and this code is required, only two lines of code. Proxy object already we created, so we no need to create it once again. Just I'm going to decide the behavior. No need to create the mock object again. Find name by ID. What is wrong with my keyboard? Yeah, proxy object created. For first method, we have decided the behavior. Now, for second method, we are trying to decide the behavior. The code is already available. Just I'm taking this code. And I will keep in that init method. And I'm keeping in the init method. Right, finally, replay. Injecting the dependent object also, do I need to do in every method? Or I know that in the every method, this logic also I no need to do in the every method, because only one time we can inject the mock object to the target. So for this, here I'm going to create one class level variable, private static contact service IMPL, service is equal to null. Service is equal to null. Now, when I will inject the object is, once the mocking is completed, then I will inject the object. Once the mocking is completed, then I'm going to inject the object. Once mocking is ready, then I'm going to inject the object to my service IMPL. Now observe, service is equal to new contact service IMPL. Service dot set contact DOM. Now I am able to inject it. Now, is this logic required here? Not required. Just I'm going to call service dot get name by ID. Is this logic required here? Is this logic required here? Not required. So just I'm going to, now you can see clean test. Clean test code is available in our method, because the proxy logic we extracted to a separate method, which is called init method. That method is going to execute before our class execution. So at the rate before class annotation I have given, my proxy logic is available there. In this method directly I am calling the service layer method and validating the result. Here also directly I am calling the service layer method and I am validating the result. Earlier in this method also I was creating the proxy. In this method also I was creating the proxy, which will become a boilerplate code. So to avoid the boilerplate code, I extracted the common logics of these two methods and I kept inside one method, which is called init method. Here proxy creation, setting behavior for the first method, setting the behavior for the second method, and activating that proxy. Then creating the object for the target class and injecting dependent object into our target. Are you able to understand the code that we optimizing now? Or anybody has any confusion over this? Anybody has any confusion, or you are clear with this? All of you. Please confirm, sir. I have not done any changes as of, I have not done any new lines of code. Just I extracted the code from two methods and I kept in one method. It is just a organization. It is just a organization. Whatever the common code available in the two methods, I just copied, I just extracted the common code. I kept inside the init method. Earlier, what we are doing? Earlier, we are doing the proxy creation in this method also and in this method also. In the two places, we are doing the proxy. But now, at only one place we are creating the proxy and we are setting the behavior for the proxy. So no need to write that boilerplate code in the two methods. In the first approach, boilerplate code was available. Now clean code is available in our test class. Only one reference variable, sir. DAO proxy, for that I'm setting the behavior. DAO proxy, I'm setting the behavior for the second. This is the final saving the behavior. That's it. Only one proxy, two methods behavior we are setting at a time. Now, I want to set the behavior for third method also. What is that? Find by ID. The people who are using laptop, can you write the code and send me? How I need to mock this method? Come on, fast. I'm waiting for 2 minutes. Please send me the code. I want to mock this method which is returning an object. I want to see what code you will do. Just write in the notepad and paste here. I want to see your coding skill. Come on, guys. Perfect. Right. Yes. Now see here, how can I do that mocking? So go to our test class. Here, set the mock behavior. Right. So in order to set the mock behavior, first I need to have the contact object. Contact C is equal to new contact. Because this is the object that has to return by that method. It is the object that has to return by the method. Now we'll set some dummy data, contact ID as some 101. C dot set some contact name as some value. C dot set contact number. C dot set contact number. 1 second. We don't set contact number, some number I'm going to set. Fine. This is the behavior. Right now, in order to set the behavior for this, we are going to write easymock dot expect DAO proxy dot find by ID expect DAO dot find by ID means some ID. I'm going to set it as a 101. Then return. And return contact object that we created. So for three methods, behaviors we are setting in the init method only, right? Setting behavior for proxy, setting behavior for DAO method one, Now here, setting behavior for DAO method two. Here we are setting behavior for method two. Setting behavior for DAO method 2. Here I'm setting the behavior for DAO method 3. Right. Here activating a saving proxy behavior. Here injecting proxy object into target object. So that is the code that is there inside our DAO method. Are you able to follow this, or do you have any confusion in this code? Don't count how many number of lines we are writing. Just understand what we are writing, why we are writing. If you count the number of lines, you will get confused. Array sir, these many lines of code he has written. Don't check the count. Just understand why we are doing that. Is there any difficulty in that? Step by step we are building this. Step by step we are building this. So that confidence should be there for you. So tomorrow when you are also going to work in the real-time project, so this, like this only, whenever one method is completed, for that method you need to perform the unit testing by using mocking like this. So parallelly, business logic we will write and mock logic also we are going to write to perform unit testing. All of you clear with this init method code? All of you clear with the init method code? Good. Now let us test it. Public void test. Public void test. What is the method in the IMPL? Get contact by ID. Public void test. Get contact by ID. Right. Now what I will do? Service dot get contact by ID. I will pass 101. Now which is going to return. Why get name by ID? No, get contact by ID. I want to get the object, right? Why this method is not there? Edit and save it. Get contact by ID. Service dot service dot get contact by ID 101. We have decided the behavior for the 101. The return value is the contact object. When I pass 101, it has to return contact. Asset not null. Asset not null, because I have decided the behavior for that 101, so it has to return me that contact object. It has to return me that contact object. So are you clear with this test? Get test get contact by ID underscore 01. This is the 01 first case for our contact by ID. I am passing 101, I am expecting contact object. If the contact object is not null, then my test is passed. My service layer method is working as expected. Now, I want to test only this one now. For that, I am going to specify ignore for the previous one. So total three tests are available. Two tests I ignored and only one test I am activating. Only this current test is going to execute. Now, keep a breakpoint at the 69th line number. Right click, debug as junit test. Fine, get into this. Already our before class method got executed, our proxy behavior already ready. Proxy is already injected to service as part of the init method. Now directly our test is executing. Go inside this test method. Now observe the carefully. Contact DAO.find by ID. ID what I am passing 101. For the 101, already I have decided the behavior. Hey, proxy, if somebody calls this method with 101, then return this contact object. That is what I told to my proxy. So at the 43 line number, already I have decided the behavior for the contact ID 101. So what is the behavior? When somebody calls this method with 101, then you return this contact object data, contact object with this data. That is what the behavior I have already decided for that. Now F6, check this contact. Yes, exactly. It is returning the same data. Contact ID 101, name is Charles, number is given value. So even though the implementation not available for the DAO method is returning a object with the data. The reason is this 43 line number. The reason is this 43 line number. Even though that is not available, I am asking the proxy to return the object with some data. This is the object and this is the data. So I told to my proxy, somebody may call this method with 101 as a parameter, then you return this object. So it is returning, as I told, it is returning my contact data. If contact is equal to not equal to, if it is equal to null, then it has to throw the exception. But in this scenario, it is not null. So if condition will not satisfy. If condition is not going to satisfy. Now, F6, returning a contact object, a set not null. That contact object is not null, then our test is going to be passed. Then our JUnit test is going to be passed. Guys, did you understand how to test our service method now? Or do you have any questions in this? Do you have any questions in this? Please respond. No. Good. Now, let me test a negative scenario for this. Suppose I will pass contact ID as 0. I will pass the contact ID as a 0. Is there any behavior for the ID 0 in the proxy? There is a behavior only for 101. But there is no behavior for if the contact ID is 0. Then I want to see what is going to happen. Public void test get contact by ID underscore 02. Public void test get contact by ID underscore 02. Fine. Service dot get contact by ID with the number as some 201 or any value. Then I'm going to get this contact object. But actually it is not required. My expectation is if I pass 201, it has to throw me a no data found exception. Is my method is throwing the exception or not? That is what I want to test. So if I pass 201, is there any behavior for that? There is no behavior. Did I set any behavior for the ID 201? I set the behavior only for the ID 101. I set the behavior only for the ID 101. Now, here I am calling this method with ID as a 201. For the 201, there is no behavior. Now let us see what will happen. Let me keep a breakpoint at the 77. Now, I will ignore this also. Now I will execute only this second test case, which is for the same method called get contact by ID. When I pass 101, our case was passed because for the 101, proxy knows what it has to do. But now proxy doesn't know what it has to do for the 201 because I did not tell to proxy what it has to do. I did not tell to the proxy what it has to do when somebody called this method with the 201 as a parameter. Right. Debug as JUnit test. At the 78 line number breakpoint is there. Now get inside this method. Fine. Contact DAO, we are calling find by ID. ID I am passing as 201. There is no behavior for the 201 ID in the proxy. Now check it. What will happen? It is throwing some exception, right? Now check what happened here. It got terminated in the middle. So it is getting here and it is throwing some target effect exception available in the reflective callable from the JUnit package. Reflective callable package, right? Now let us do one thing. Let me set some dummy behavior for that also. Easy mock dot expect DAO proxy dot find by ID with 201, then return and return null value. So if you call this find by ID method with the ID 201, then proxy is going to return null value for you. If a proxy returns null value, is my logic is executing or not? Is it throwing the exception or not? I want to test it. So what is my unit testing scenario here? If a proxy returns a null value, is it throwing the exception or not? That I want to test. Fine. Now execute debug as junit test. Get into that method F5, F6. What is the value available now? Null. What the proxy method has written? Null. The reason I passed that ID as a 201. For the 201, I told to my proxy to return a null value. If it is null, what is happening? Exception is occurring. Right, F6 throw new no data found exception. This is a user defined exception. This is user defined exception. Now F8. So even though it is throwing the exception, why our test case got passed here? Even though the code is throwing an exception in the runtime, why our test case is showing as passed? Can anybody guess and tell me the answer? Whenever exception occurs, it has to terminate abnormally. But actually, why it is showing it as passed? In the JUnit, we are expecting this exception only. That is the reason it is saying that it is passed. So as part of our coding, as part of our method, several times we are going to throw exceptions. If the data is not available, we will throw exception. Whenever this exception is throwing by the method, I want to test it. Is it exactly throwing that exception or not? Is it throwing that exception or not? That is the scenario we tested recently. So whether it is throwing the exception or not, if the DAO method is returned a null value, my service layer method throwing the exception properly or not, I want to test it. For that only I have written the unit test scenario. Now this is a negative scenario. If I pass 101, the record is coming. If I pass 201, it is throwing the exception. Yes, it has to work like that. So tomorrow when the DAO method available, if the DAO is returning the data, then my service layer has to return the same data back. But if the DAO is not returning the data, then my service layer should throw the exception. Now it is throwing as expected. Now I am confident about my method. Now I am confident about my service method. So why? Because I tested both positive scenario and I tested negative scenario also. I tested positive scenario and I have tested negative scenario. Now I am more confident about my method. All right, tomorrow if DAO give the data, my method will return that object. If the DAO don't give the data, my method will throw the exception. It is perfect. It is perfect now. So such kind of confidence I am getting once I complete the unit testing of my method with both positive scenario and negative scenario. Are you guys are clear with this one? What is the advantage of going for unit testing? Right guys, thank you.